Welcome, welcome everyone. Welcome back, I guess, to week three of our Misfits dynasty, our Misfits franchise. So, between this and last episode, actually, I will. So between now, between last episode and this episode, I acquired Theommy Brown for Josh Allen and Jalen Reagor. He was unwanted. He was on the trade block. Just want to make sure I didn't do anything else. Then the star of this episode, DeMar Hamlin. You all know what happened to him. Not going into what happened to him. He was on the trade block for a sixth round pick. I did edit him. And yes, I will get into that in a second. I edited DeMar Hamlin, and you will see what I did. I have not done anything else to the team. I have not done anything super major. I just needed. Those are really going to be the last ones. I will look at the trade block today. But I am not going after high 70s. The only player I have changed on this entire team is DeMar Hamlin. He was a 66 normal. I know you guys in the comments are going to yell at me for this, but he was a 66 normal. Due to everything that's happened recently, I made him an 84 with the X Factor. He has a 95 speed, 95 Excel, 90 awareness, 99 hit power, set mo everything else is the same. And then you scroll down, 90 catching, 99 injury, 99 stamina, 99 toughness. That explains everything you need to know. I gave him X Factor, but he came with momentum shift. Not changing that. Unless you want me to give him selfless, which is the only other one I will touch. Not doing anything else besides that. And he is now the captain, aka the best player on our team. I am not changing anything else. I'm gonna show you guys the trade block so you know I'm not just yoinking these players out of nowhere. I could get a better running back, but I'm fine with the running back we have now. Could get you better wide receivers, probably not. Could get someone like Colby Parkinson at tight end, or Larry Borum at left tackle, or Kendrick Green, which I might do in between episodes, but I don't need him. I could get a better center. I'm not going to do that. Not gonna do anything in my offensive line. What you're seeing in this team is what you get. I'm not gonna trade for Milton Williams or Bobby Brown unless you guys want me to. Or even Epenesa. If you guys want me to, I will, but I'm not gonna do it just to get a better player. I'm fine with our team. Okay, Divine Diablo might be someone I trade for. Because if I remember correctly, he has like 90 speed. 88 speed, yeah. But I'm not gonna really trade for anyone else. This is the team that you see is the team that you're gonna get. Unless you guys ask me to trade for someone. Or there's someone I can't refuse that comes on the trade block. So I'm not really looking at anyone on off on in terms of quarterbacks, because we have, as you saw in the last in the episode 2 episodes ago, we got Brock Purdy. We don't really need halfbacks because we have Dameon Pierce. We don't really need wide receivers. I do have this guy because he looks really good so far. Elite, great to elite, solid to good, and then great to elite speed. That's what I want in a corner. A carrying, B medium, A release. That looks pretty damn good. But he's the only wide receiver I'm gonna go for. We have a lot more holes to fill than just that. We have left tackles. We have our right tackle. We have our linebackers, our corners. We have so many issues that I can't just say, oh, I'm gonna go out and draft a quarterback because we need one. And as you guys should know, this is a relocation. So we're gonna be relocating at some point, probably starting next year. But we're gonna be going into this game against the Chicago Bears. If you guys want me to start simming more of these games, I will. Or not playing as much or whatever. But I might stop playing after a week. I'll look at the schedule after this game.
Today.
Okay, so we are kicking off. And this is on All Pro, by the way.
It's
so.
The first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports.
I'm only going to be recording this one episode tonight, y'all. I might work on more on Saturday and Sunday, but today is Thursday, and
Fields passing on the first play from scrimmage, and they're able to get this one across the 35. For Claypool in last week's game. Four catches, 67 yards, and a touchdown.
Had a nice season. Number 8 in the league in receiving yards, and not just making his team.
Oh, this is Zach Factor might not be. Might not even be on this field.
First carry now for David Montgomery. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the field.
Hold on. It would be really funny is if he was injured. I think he is hurt. Which I didn't think about, but you know. Or is he just not on this team? Jesus Christ, there are so many injured. Wait, hold on. Or is he? Please stop. I'm so confused. Hold on. Give me a second, y'all. No, Hamlin's right there. Oh, okay. He's just not the starter right now. Okay, understood.
He gets maybe three.
There he is.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. They'll keep pounding here with Montgomery.
Okay, that was just lucky.
Five, and it brings up third down. We'll see what they
we have two strong safeties
line,
that are amazing.
First down. Fields. And that will be incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. Texans will take over with a first and 10. Purdy looking to throw on first down here. That's complete. It's Collins. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a second and about a foot. They run with a rookie from Florida, Damian Pierce. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. The numbers on the ground for Pierce last week. 18 carries, 85 yards, and a touchdown.
They've won two straight games and have done it with the running game as the focal point of their offense. So in this contest, I don't think about doing anything else. I continue to ride the hot hand that I've established and lead with the runners.
De'Ami Brown, the intended receiver.
Yeah, that was a pass interference, but I guess the game is just not going to call it.
Remember, no first-round picks this year. They traded it away. How much of a detriment is that?
Well, what they're hoping is the reason they traded away the
first-round pick. Kidding me?
Won't be a detriment.
I have not changed the settings at all with the how tough it is. So
that's when your scouting comes to the front. You have to hit on those selections.
Eluding the pressure right. He's got his man. It's Pierce. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Now on fourth down, it's Cameron Johnston on to punt it away. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Over on the sideline, hoping to hit that reset button between possessions. Last time out, they had to punt it away. This time, hoping to finish this thing off in the end zone. And they'll get eight out of this before being stopped at the 28. One play action. Fields steps away. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken
down. Oh, my God. Christian Harris.
Christian Harris brings him down, and that's a play he's going to remember. The first sack of his NFL career. From the gun on third down, Fields able to hit his target, Claypool. And they will rally and stop him short of the first down. They get him to the ground at the 26. On fourth down, Matt Araiza sent on to punt. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. Now Austin. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return. And the Texans will take over. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. First and 10. First and 10, it's Pierce.
But there's a flag, probably holding. Yep. First and 20. Oh, first and 17. That's interesting.
Defender trying to set the edge in the running game, and you're trying to drive around and get your body twisted so that he can't get there. Sometimes your hands get too involved.
Launches deep. A jump ball. Holy shit. Touchdown, Texans. John Ross, his first touchdown here of the new campaign.
That was a amazing play.
Fairbairn good with the extra point, and that makes
nice.
The score 7-0. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Back to Montgomery on second down. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. The Texans here on third down, putting an extra defender in the secondary. towards Fields. Caught here by Griffin. And this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29.
Okay, I'm definitely gonna change some of the sliders to be a little harder.
And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. The danger of a punt that good, a 16-yard return. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. On first down, it's Purdy. Swings this one out wide for Pierce. Good cover defensively as they get to him just beyond the 45 after the broken tackle. After one, 7-0.
I'm not trying to have this team be really good this quickly.
Throwing again on second down.
And that's a 3-yard loss.
And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Purdy with it on third and long. Escaping the pressure right.
That was, I shouldn't have thrown that. I should have just kind of taken my sack or taken my throwing away.
Try not to do too much on an individual play because, as we all know, sometimes less is more. And throwing away is preferable to making the big mistake.
And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. On second down, Montgomery trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. The Bears on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This time it's third and 3. He's got a man open. It's Chase Claypool. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Up the middle, it's Montgomery. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Read option, here's Montgomery. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Here's Fields. Yeah, he has his tight end, that's Wesco. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 15-yard line. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. This is Montgomery with a grab over the middle. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. This is a 2nd and 4, ball at the 9. Now Fields. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They're putting together a drive here in the final minutes of the half. So the coverage has been tight all game long, and they certainly want to keep them off the scoreboard here.
He'll be hit and taken down at the 20.
Jefferson, oh my God.
Jefferson gets in there to drop him for a loss of 13 yards, and it's also 4th down now. Santos' kick is up and through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game, and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them.
Now a hit and a loose football.
Oh my God, I knew that was going to happen eventually.
They will take over at the 26-yard line.
Oh my God. Now everything's unraveling. Fun.
On first down, Fields. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
I want this to be harder, but I guess the game's like, yeah, no, you're just going to randomly fumble.
From the gun, here's Fields. Over the middle, that's caught by Harry. The broken tackle could not.
I've forgotten Nikhil Harry was on this team.
Throw again on second down. Fields. And
I guess I did want this to be harder, but not this infuriating. And the Bears have taken the lead. Yeah, because my player randomly decided to fumble.
Touchdown reception. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Here comes another drive from this unit, and Charles, they're coming off a costly mistake on the last possession, an interception in a game that is very close right now.
Well, as we know, they all sting no matter what the situation, but in a one-possession game, that'll hurt a little bit more. But this is an excellent opportunity to make up for it on this drive. I just don't expect them to try and take huge gambles to make up that momentum in a hurry.
He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. There's Purdy on first and 10. Over the middle, complete. It's Ross. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. Again, it's Purdy to throw it. On the move past the 40. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Gets the dump off to Pierce. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Second and 8 coming up. Back to throw, Purdy. Flushed out right. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the 2. They'll run here with Pierce. And he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Houston.
I just can't rely on my passing game right now. Sorry, I'm just like not spacing out, but I'm trying to just focus.
Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And the lead is now 14-10.
This is what I want in a Madden game, is yes, I'm irritated, but I'm having fun. That's the difference, is I'm having fun with this while being irritated.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. A final shot before the break. Fields is going to loft one deep over the middle. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. So we have reached halftime here.
Halftime, 14-10.
As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Time to give you folks at home a look around the NFL on this first official weekend of fall. So let's get to it. We'll get started up at Lucas Oil Stadium in the capital city of Indianapolis. And it's the Chiefs who have the lead in that one. Patrick Mahomes looking good. 2 touchdown passes. From there, we head to Foxborough to check on the Patriots at home at Gillette Stadium. And at this point, they trail the visiting Baltimore Ravens. Sammy Watkins, 1 touchdown reception.
But no break needed. Let's get back to it. Week 3, here we go with quarter 3. It's the Texans in front, and they're going to get the football first as we are back underway in the 3rd quarter. The Texans offense ready.
Like, I want a game where I have to be very methodical.
I would imagine the overall halftime tone was a positive one, but what do you think the talking points were in the locker room?
Well, if there were 3 talking points at the half, partner, all of them were about because they were pretty loose with the ball. Otherwise, this lead could be even bigger. Now, I don't think that they overly harped on it, but I think they told them, guys, if you want to keep calling these plays that are exciting, you got to take care of the ball. Otherwise, we may have to dial things back a little bit.
Yomi Brown.
1 yard here to pick up the first down. And they'll go jet sweep to try to pick it up.
I should have just continued to run.
It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs. Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right now. Hotly contested in the third quarter. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. And Pierce gets it again on second down. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. Purdy to throw it on first down. And he fires one incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. Pierce will try to pick it up. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24.
I'm glad I have a receiver I can, like, do this stupid little...
Now here's a little touch pass as they tap it.
He is just so slow. Dear God. He is, like, he's not slow, but he is slower than what I'm used to.
And got his man, it's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Josh Gordon from 6 yards.
The return of Josh Gordon.
Texans take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Fairbairn good with the extra point, and that makes it a 21-10 game. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Well, the opposition laid down the challenge and opening drive touchdown here to start the second half. And Charles, now you feel like this group needs to get an answer because this all of a sudden is a two-score game.
Yeah, you're right about that.
He fought a lot for, a one-yard game that was? A 0-yard?
Right, pressure is on because you don't want them getting the ball back with a chance to really extend this lead out.
There's the option going left on second down. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. That's what he can do, you know, when he keeps the football. It's not a huge game, but it shows how hard it can be to stop it.
Yeah, and I thought the defense had that one pretty well contained, and in fact, they probably came up and felt pretty good about what they did. Then they looked up and realized he still got good yardage out of it. He's a tough guy to stop.
From the 50, here's Fields. And it's hauled in by St. Brown over the middle.
Oh yeah, they have Equinemius St. Brown, right? I can't remember his name. I think it's Equinemius. God.
They'll try the middle with Montgomery. It's a 6-yard gain on the
I should have blown that up. I just whiffed on that tackle.
You just gotta stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter. No time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall.
It's Bears football, but they trail on the scoreboard as we get set to bring you the fourth quarter. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Okay, that should have gone for much more. I guess it just got tripped by the turf monster.
Usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. To throw on second and six, Fields. And Fields going to have the first down before sliding to a halt to avoid the contact. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Going up the gut, Montgomery. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line.
See, this is the stuff I want, is where I can't stop their team. I can, but it's, like, very hard to.
They'll go option to the short side. And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15.
Also, I only have three cornerbacks, so when you see, like, both my strong safeties.
Bring up fourth down.
21-13.
Santos' kick is up and through, and that'll make this an 8-point game. All right, so they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a three and out here to get the ball back. Preferably a takeaway.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Their lead back down to one score after the field goal a moment ago, so they'll be looking to string together a few first downs, likely on the ground as they begin first and 10. The false start backs them up five, first and 15. Purdy. Down, still a nice 13-yard pickup. Only needing 2 yards on second down. On second down, here's Pierce.
Did I get it? Oh, I just barely got it.
The drive continues. It's a first down. Play action now, Purdy. He's going deep for Brown. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. To throw on second and 10. Purdy got a man open. It's Ross. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. So the false start will back them up five.
Oh, my God. I need to stop doing those fake hikes.
The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
Purdy from the gun on third down. Got a man. It's Collins complete. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Will John Ross beat out his man? Probably not. But whoever that is, beat their man, Deami Brown.
And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. To throw again on second down. Purdy. Looking up. Oh, no, he lost the football. And this is picked up by the Bears.
And that's what I get for trying to hurdle.
Team football gets tested a little bit because I know the defense
this
guys
should,
are over there chilling on
these
the sidelines.
Fumble
sudden,
should theoretically
the call that
cost me the game or get close to costing me the game, which they are doing a pretty damn good job at.
Here now is second and 10. Fields
Rasheem Green. All right.
Final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively, pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
Throw right side, taken in by Pettis. And they're going to get this down inside the 20. First down now, but that clock rolling. Here's Fields. Dancing to his left. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. He'll get this underneath to Montgomery. And they're going to be set up now with the ball at the 13-yard line. All eyes on Fields. Forced out to his left. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down. He broke that line of scrimmage and then let it fly, and that's an automatic flag.
Yeah, and you know, you don't just lose the 5 yards there, but you lose a down as well. So he obviously needs to have better awareness about what he's going to do. Either tuck it in.
DeMar Hamlin.
Potential daggers. It's intercepted. And the Texans have just about shown up this football game. That Charles, the first interception he's thrown here in year number two.
Oh my God, DeMar freaking Hamlin.
Like what we saw from him last year, where he was plagued by this type of a play, and they thought that, you know, over the offseason, going into a second season, some of that would go away. Thus far, still looks a lot like his rookie year.
Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10. And Pierce gets it again on second down. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7.
Now a second. I know what the title of this episode now.
That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Here's where this crowd can really help make things difficult. It's 3rd and 3. On third down, here's Pierce.
That was a bad play by me. Oh, Lord.
Here's Cameron Johnston now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Taking it about the 16.
Did that? Was that what I think it was? Oh, okay. I thought it was holding on my team.
Start the next drive.
Yeah, that's a pretty easy call right there, partner. I think when the official look in their manual and see the expression "jersey getting pulled," that's a flag coming out every time.
Final throw here is incomplete, and that is how this one will come to an end.
Well,
it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide a winner, although on that last play,
DeMar
so
freaking Hamlin
taking a miracle, and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it, because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play, and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded, because we've seen the improbable before. A couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end. They might have gone all the way to the end zone. In this case, though, it didn't happen. Perhaps next time.
Oh, my God.
So for the Texans, it's an ideal start as they move to 3-0 now on the young season. Head home next week to take on the L.A. Chargers. Meanwhile, for Chicago, they suffer defeat for the first time as they drop to 2-1.
Nope, that's not what I want.
And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to MetLife Stadium to take on the New York Giants.
Nope, that's not the key I wanted. Sorry, guys.
Inside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gordon. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Is it? I'm struggling how to print screen or to get a screenshot here. Nope. Give me a second, y'all. Okay, I think that got a screenshot. Frickin' DeMar Hamlin. Okay, I'm thinking about simming the rest of these. Probably not, maybe, no. I'm definitely resigning you. All right, let's see. Oh yeah, it was Rasheem Green who did get a pretty. That's $2 million over 1 year. I'm not worried. Yeah, I can do that for you. And then before we wrap things up, I'm gonna just check the Beignet trade. Anyone like really outstanding has gotten onto the trade block. I mean, I doubt it, but okay, Elijah Mitchell and Antonio Gibson and Khalil Herbert and Michael Carter. Okay. Osborne. But again, I don't really need a running back. Ooh, Noah Gray. Is there any corners? 24. I'm just gonna try this. Him and a seventh. Okay, what about him and a fifth? Nope. Okay, I'm not trying that. But thank you all for watching. And I will probably see you guys in the next video. Peace. Wherever my mouse is. Okay, well, give me a second. Because I guess my mouse just doesn't want to work right now. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.